Hey family, how y'all doing today? I hope you're having a wonderful and blessed day no matter where you are in the world. I'm visualizing the Gambia, but no y'all, I'm in the USA. Visualizing, doing my best. Wearing gifts from my sister. She's such a talented artist, y'all. She hand did these for me a while back. My food forest earrings. Now my necklace from Cameroon. My bracelet, y'all, from Cameroon, I guess. And from one of the vendors at the Pan-African pop-up shops. I'm all about cooperative economics no matter where I go. And accepting beautiful gifts from loved ones. How has your New Year's been going for y'all? I hope it's an improvement over last year. No matter what's going on in your life, I hope it's improving. Y'all, I want to take y'all to the Gambia with me on a virtual trip. You don't need no goggles to get there, y'all. You just come with me. They've been working so hard, our team has. And no, contrary to popular belief, they are not employees except one guy. And that's our MVP. Our land manager. He goes into the food forest all during the week, y'all. Yes, all during the week. And make sure that the plants are watered properly and that everything's going well. And to make sure that the monkeys are getting a little snack here and there. If we had more donations, we would give them more food because we got to buy it because we ain't building our crops up yet to be able to feed them directly from the crops. Because in fair share, we want to share with everyone, including our team members that's out there. Because they have to know if what they're doing is working. And part of that evaluation process is eating some of the fruits of your labor. Then that way you'll know if you're improving on how they taste, if the texture is changing. You'll know what you did right. And you'll know the things that you have to improve on. So it's very important to have the fair share for our team as well. So they harvest and they take home some of the fruits of their labor. And we do share with the monkeys, but sometimes we have to buy our groundnuts and fruits from vendors in the market. Even though I don't know where the market is anymore since all of this clearing things happening. So only they know because they are boots on the ground over there. But anyway, y'all, come with me to Jambanjeli and see what our team of students, permaculture students, and that's a lifelong process, learning to grow what you eat and eat what you grow. It's a lifelong process for me as well. So come, y'all, come with me to Jambanjeli, West Africa, a wonderful African village community.
So I think the war has just begun with the ant. The last time we share our opinion concerning about the ant, but we are very grateful for the information we had from you that the use of vinegar. Thank God today we started And we'll keep monitoring and see how effective it is. So we just want to share that.
Yeah.
If you have a problem, as long as you share, always come with solution. So we have started applying the vinegar. Yeah, thank you so much for your wisdom, and we hope it works. Yeah, once it works, then it will pay dividend. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Okay, like I said in my previous video, today we did harvesting of cassava. The sticks are the one that we put over there for reservation, and this is our cassava cube. Like I always say, cassava like is becoming very expensive and costly in the market. The market value is getting high and high. It is because people are not involved in agriculture. Many people are running away from agriculture. And this is a big sign that people should go back to farming, especially on carbohydrate foods. Because in Africa, and half of the population, I can say entirely, the half of the population in Africa depends on carbohydrate food, like rice, cassava and stuff. Even in Ghana, Nigeria and Gambia, it is very valuable. Because in Gambia, you can say the staple food in Gambia is rice, but in Nigeria and Ghana, they depend on fufu mostly. Cassava, you can use it to make flour, you can use it to make curry, which is also a dish, and you can use the cassava to make traditional food in the Gambia like ebe, and use it as a side dish in your cooking, like stew or even on benachim. So what I would like to say finally is that people should try and involve in permaculture, because it is the only way out. Like, the crop that you grow and you harvest it for yourself and you eat it, it's more safe than the crop that you buy outside, because you don't know how many years it has been there. Because like this cassava, it can be taken to the Western World, package and put in fridge. You don't know how many years it has been there, but if you grow it for yourself, it is more healthier. As the saying goes, a healthy food is a healthy life. So permaculture is the healthy now. Thank you. This is what we harvested for today.
Yes, good afternoon, Fatima.
Good afternoon, Uncle Yankuba, and good afternoon to the members of Habasia Food Forest. It's another Sunday, and we are back to the Jambanjeri Food Forest. Today, we did watering, check the plants, and we even did harvesting of cassava. As you can see, the cassava sticks. We've come to the end of the day. Today we harvested our cassava, so the cassava fruit is over there. Now the sticks are the one that we reserve here. As you can see, we are going to put the sticks here, because if you stuck them inside the ground and you're watering them, they will not get dry, and you can use it for next year rainy season, because we are in winter in Gambia. And as you all know, Gambia, we have three weather systems: winter, the Hamatan season, and then the rainy season. So soon we will come to the rainy season. As like traditionally, this is what we found our great grandparents doing, and even our parents. This is what we found them doing. If you harvest the cassavas, instead of throwing the sticks, we not throw the sticks. We just take the sticks, stuck them inside the ground, be watering them daily so that it can be used for next year, because soon the rain will start again. Because Gambia, we have 4 to 5 months rain, and then we come to winter. So the sticks are here for reservation for the next rainy season. And finally, I would like to say thank you to every one of you who have been with us since day one, subscribing to our YouTube channel, donating, liking our videos, and sharing our videos. We cannot thank you guys enough, because without you guys, we would not have been this part of the food forest. And finally, I would like to say a big thank you to the mother of the organization, Stephanie Nwade, for her immense effort towards the success of the food forest. And to all my co-workers, thank you so much for being patient and competent in what we are doing. Thank you so much. Till another Sunday.
Next time,
This is cassava sticks. We are, you know, just put in here. Maybe next rain season we have good varieties. This is cassava tree, very nice.
Okay.
And then his, you know, his fruit, they are very, you know, good. That's why we keep in here and then
very good
water so that can survive.
Hello everyone, as usual, today is Sunday. I say good afternoon. So it is just now that we completed the watering, but nevertheless, we try to harvest the cassava. See, this is the least we could have harvested. If we don't harvest this, we would have lost all this to the monkeys, as my brother said. But in permaculture, it's a food forest. Yes, we are sharing, but in as much as we are sharing, we should not forget our share too. So this is our share from the Habasia food forest. Decision making in agriculture is very key. So if you realize that there's a problem that you cannot stop, you have an alternative. Farmers say go for the alternative. In as much as we want to create better life for every creation, we have to look at what is also at our interest. So we are very grateful. We don't underrate what we lose, but alhamdulillah, we are grateful. So this is no small amount of what we can get from the food forest. So I'm grateful to the team for being so patient with me, always following our decision together, because it's not easy to lead. Sometimes make decision, yes, difficult, but you have to. So that's why I say we cannot lose all. That's why today I say we must harvest, and that's what we did. Thank you. This is what we can share. So thank you so much. Yeah, until later. Yeah. So we can now remove. Yeah. So you can go different location.
Guys, what do you think? Were you encouraged by what they have done? And such a small time, y'all. 1 year of growth in that food forest, y'all. 1 year of growth. Because we don't even count before we got our fence up high enough to what? Keep the cows out. We used to have our neighbors' cows coming in there. Seemed like they was in the Olympics, y'all. Even though we had a little border fence, them cows were like jumping, like the cow jump over the moon. They would jump over our fence. I don't know how they did it, y'all. But anyway, the fence is up high enough to keep the cows out, but still low enough to when we have neighbors one day to say, hey, how you? And they can say, fine, and you. Because, yeah, in the Gambia, they use that greeting as well. It may not even be in English, but, you know, it still sounds the same to me. And when they respond, it sounds the same. So when I'm in the Gambia, I feel at home. And when I say home, y'all, I be talking about Galveston, because when I grew up in Galveston, it was like little Africa to me, because it was segregation, and we had colored everything. We had a colored Catholic church, Holy Rosary, that I attended, including Holy Rosary School. And so that was most of my life, you know, with the Sisters of the Holy Family. Yeah, they was colored too, y'all. The only thing we had that was Caucasian was the priests. And sometimes, y'all, we got African priests. Yeah, our African brothers. So it was nice growing up. So when I hear some people talk about that they feel sorry for people because of them not having equal access, I'm thinking they don't understand that we did just fine. We just wanted equal opportunities. But me growing up in that environment, it was like my mentality didn't really have to change when I went to the motherland. So I went from majority thinking to majority thinking. I never thought of myself as any minority anyway. And even once we integrated, I felt a culture shock, isolation from some of the students in my class because I end up with a class of people that didn't look like me. But then on the weekends, we partied hard, y'all, and we was back to Africa at the parties. Saying away, it's like going back in time, back to when we had interactions with the majority of the people looking like us for long periods of time and being in a room of people that didn't look like me was different. I adjusted though, y'all. I'm good now. I can survive and thrive in any environment. But anyway, y'all, if you have not subscribed, please do. I appreciate and love all of you. I love all of humanity, y'all. Irregardless of anything, long as you human, I'm good with you. And y'all know I love me some monkeys and squirrels and trees and lizards. And wow, the Most High is good, y'all, all the time. I'm just so happy that I can see with my two eyes. And let me not go too long. I don't want to hold y'all too long. But anyway, y'all, if you want to be a part of the change that you want to see in the world, consider helping us. It may be simple as subscribing if you have not, liking, commenting down below, and sharing our videos to everyone that you know. That won't cost you anything. But it'll help us so much for our channel to grow. And if you are so led by the Most High to donate to us, no matter how small, y'all, it all adds up. And we need people like you to give. We are blessed to be a blessing to others. So please consider us in your giving. We're a 501c3, so don't let giving your maximum hold you back. You can deduct it if you so choose. Just talk to your tax preparer about that. But anyway, y'all, I love you all. I appreciate y'all. Thank you for everybody who's ever donated to Habasia. That really helps with everything. We pay our employee, one employee full time. Every week we pay him. And y'all, we pay him more than what he gets paid. He would have gotten paid regular Gambian rate. We pay him more. And he's free to go to the food forest at the time he wants to go. And he just stays till he gets the job done. And he is the evaluator of that. And then he does pictures and videos and uploads them to WhatsApp so we can see what all he's done. He's a good guy. And we pay for the food stuffs for the monkeys and for seeds and plants for the food forest and fix generators and gas and maintaining it and paying for transport for our team to go back and forth to Debo House where they meet the van that is hired privately every week to take them there and back. I'm telling you, every penny that you donate will be used 100% for the food forest. There's no fat in any of the donations. No advertising, marketing, payrolls other than that one person. But so many people are learning so much, y'all. It's making a difference in so many people's lives. I heard even people are starting gardens because they are motivated by our food forest. Yeah, people in the Gambia are starting to do gardens again because they're motivated by watching our videos. I hope all of you out there will be motivated to what? Plant some seeds. Plant a tree. Share these videos. And when, I say when you donate, please share. Because it will come up after you pay. The little button to share with your family and friends that you donated. It really helps a lot to spread the word, the good news of what we're doing. Habari Gani, not just doing Kwanzaa time. We live like that all year long, y'all. What's the news? Habasia is the news. It's the signal, y'all. It is. And I'm here doing my thing every day. Praying I win the lottery, but not yet, y'all. Not yet. In the Most High's time. Oh, y'all. Go out there. Make the world a better place. Have a wonderful and blessed day. Peace. Peace. Power to the people. And I'm out, y'all. Remember, Habasia, man, woman, child, Africa, where all human beings came from. Bye.